here today with Patrick from CloudRail, and we have a IO-Link demo for you. What are we going to show today, Patrick?
Yeah, we're going to connect a few sensors and one actuator to AWS and to Azure today in just a few minutes.
Yeah, what we have here is IO-Link Master. We have Edge Gateway, which is the CloudRail.Box Max based on the Welotec Edge Gateway. And we have, what's that?
A tower light.
Tower light.
It can blink and it can make sounds.
Cool. We have a vibration sensor here and another temperature sensor that I will connect later. Perfect. Let's get started.
Yes. So what we see here is our device management platform. So this is where I can go and manage all of these edge gateways that I have in the field. I simply have to enter a serial number to get them connected, and then they will show up in my account. I can see if they're online, I can see if they're offline, I can see the latest firmware version, and I can also get some information about the current settings, so the MAC addresses and current IP addresses that are assigned. Now, if I want to configure them, I simply go to New Connection, I choose directly connected sensors in our case, and the management platform will then connect down to the industrial devices. Currently, we see that there is nothing connected. So if you want, you can plug in the IO-Link Masters.
Okay, great. I'll do that. So I have a network cable that is going to the IO-Link Master, and I'll plug it into the Edge Gateway now.
Okay, so what we can see now is that the IO-Link Master is connected. We can see all the 8 ports. We see that there's a tower light in port number 2. And there is a vibration sensor on port number 6. So all of that is discovered on the fly. So what we can do now is we can take the temperature sensor and also plug it into any port.
Okay, great. I'll do that.
Just hold this up here.
It's not so easy, isn't it?
No, it's not. I mean, these industrial screws are always meant to last, so.
Perfect, it's working.
Good.
Do you see it already?
Oh yeah, it's already there on port 3. So as we can see here, this is the temperature sensor that we plugged in. And yeah, I'll take the vibration sensor though for the demo because it has more fun output. So I select it, I go next. What I do now is simply select an interval. So I can say, okay, every 500 milliseconds, I want that sensor to send its data. In this case, we'll start with AWS. So we have IoT Core. We have Greengrass, we also have Sitewise. For this demo, we'll just take IoT Core because it's the easiest one to see something. I select my credentials, I enter a very descriptive name for the device and hit create. So what happens in the background is that we're connecting to the customer's AWS account. We create and register that device there. We download the credentials back to the Edge Gateway. And from that point onwards, it's already connected and sending data right away. So what I get on the platform here is simply a data schema. I can see all the different properties and values that that sensor offers. And yeah, I also get a small sample. Yeah, but let's head into my AWS account. So I can simply copy this MQTT topic, go into my AWS account. This is AWS IoT. So in here, they have a test client, which we can use. We paste the topic in here and we hit subscribe. So as you can see, the data is already coming in. It's not much fun right now, but if you want, you can take it and hit it on the desk a little bit. And we can already see the data change in pretty much real time. So yeah, that's how fast you can get, you know, simple sensors into AWS IoT. Now, what's also possible is the other way around. So since it's always fun to have some stuff blinking, we will now connect the tower light as well, in this case to Azure and specifically to IoT Central, which is basically a platform where you can visualize data more easily than if you just send it into IoT Hub or into IoT Core from AWS. So we select the tower light here. We go to the next step. We say, okay, we want RGB mode because we want to control the color, and we enable the write mode. We go next, we choose IoT Central, we select the right credentials, also give it another descriptive name and hit create. So the difference between IoT Central and IoT Hub in our case as well is that we also provide the semantic information. So we not only register the devices, send the credentials down there and send data in, but we also give the semantic information of the device to Azure. So we can, for instance, for write devices, directly send commands by simply selecting dropdowns. We can see that in a second. But first of all, we also get the same type of schema information with all the values that are possible to send and set on the device. So if I now go into my IoT Central account, I can reload the device list. Here's my fun device name. And as you can see, there's already a pre-configured write object that I can simply configure. So I can select the buzzer to no sound because it's a very annoying one. I can say, okay, I want it to blink continuously or slow, fast, whatever I want. So I'll just do blinking slow and select the color. What do you want? Red?
Red, yes, of course.
As always. And now I'm hitting run.
Oh,
as you can see, it's pretty much immediately sent down to the device and it's now flashing.
Cool. So how many sensors or different types of sensors do you support?
Right now it's over 12,000. So you can pretty much connect any IO-Link sensor to that IO-Link master and it will be discovered in the same way as you saw the other sensors to be available. You can also connect simple analog or digital sensors. Sometimes for analog you need an additional adapter, but you can also connect that there.
Okay, great.
Perfect. Want to see anything else?
That's great already. So thank you very much, Patrick.
Good.
And thanks for watching.
Thank you for watching.